tell us a little bit about yourself?
Sure. I'm a 25-year-old nautical archaeology student from Texas A&M University in the U.S., and I'm actually here at the Western Astronomy Museum studying the medical supplies from the Dutch shipwrecks Batavia and Gilt Dragon.
So what brings you over to Western Australia?
My interest is actually in shipboard medicine, particularly in the large trading companies of the 17th and 18th centuries, so I came here to work on the Dutch shipwrecks that are housed at the Western Australia Museum.
Have you found out anything particularly interesting about the surgeons of this period from your work here?
From my work, yes, I have actually. Some of the more interesting things we have are the apothecary jars that I've been working on analyzing here. And some of the things that we've been doing actually is analyzing the types of glaze that were used for them. This small type of apothecary jar is called a salve pot, and these generally held all the liquid and some of the dry materials that the surgeons used for their apothecary roll. They're glazed inside but not outside, so we've been trying to determine what type of glaze were used on these versus these kind of more large ornate majolica wares. And so I've been doing a lot of XRF analysis of both the clay types and the glaze types to determine if they all came from the same potter. So if the company hired just one ceramics potter that they used to supply their earthenware, or if they came from different institutions. And so far it actually looks like that they're pretty much a complete family. And they all have the same composition of glaze. One of the interesting things about this particular type of morphology of jar is that they only exist in the 17th century, and they're more often found on ships than on land. By the time the 18th century rolls around, we have wrecks like Gilt Dragon, the apothecary jars are all these alborelli, or the glazed majolica jars. So they're kind of definitely vestigial almost at this point as well.
And have you determined what type of materials were held in these jars?
Yeah, we have a number of pharmacopoeia from the 17th and 18th centuries that dictate the types of medicines that ship surgeons were supposed to have in their stores. Only the contents of one of the larger majolica jars survived for us to be able to analyze, and that was done back in the 70s. It turned out to be red mercuric oxide, which is a common composition for salves and plasters that were used by ship surgeons. There aren't any trace analyses left in the smaller jars to be able to determine what was once in them, but they would have held things like mercury, absinthe, calcium, oil of vitriol, just things that were used for larger compounds that the surgeons made into pills and plasters for patients aboard the ships.
And these jars that you have here, mm-hmm. which shipwrecks are they being retrieved from?
These are actually all from Batavia, these smaller ones that we have. Gilt Dragon has a couple of the larger majolica ones, but this particular type are all from Batavia. I would probably say that it actually has the largest collection of any recorded shipwreck of this particular type of apothecary jar, since it falls out of use after the 17th century. So it's actually a very unique shipwreck in that sense, and probably has one of the largest medical collections, other than Mary Rose.